Hello students, today we are going to discuss about third topic of this chapter, and that is taxonomic categories. So first of all, here you can see some categories of a taxonomy. So first of all, lower category of any taxonomy will be species. Okay, then after, over to the species, genus will be there, and over there family, then order, class, phylum and kingdom. So you can see here, so highest category is a kingdom and lowest category is a species. So let me discuss one by one what is a species, genus, family, order, class, phylum and kingdom. Okay, so here let me see this. So classification involve hierarchy of steps, okay, in which each step represents a taxonomic category, that is also called rank. Okay, so each step represents a taxonomic category. Here you can see all the steps. Okay, so it is also considered as a ranks, taxonomic ranks. All categories together constitute a taxonomic hierarchy. Okay, and each category represents a unit of a classification. A group of organisms occupying a particular category is called taxon. Okay, and plurally we can say as a taxa. For example, class Mammalia is one type of a taxa. Now let me go through categories by using one example, and we are taking example as a human. Okay, so if you are getting the information, this is the species. Okay, this is lowest category. So if you go through this, you can see human species is a sapiens. Okay, and higher the category is a genus, and the genus of a human is a homo. Then family of a human is a hominidae. Okay, then order, primata, class, mammalia. Okay, and the phylum you can see, chordata, and kingdom is animalia. So this is the hierarchy in ascending order. So you are starting from here. If you starting from here, so ascending order will be like this. Okay, so species having a sapiensis, then a genus, homo, hominidae, primata, mammalia, chordata and animalia. Animalia is a kingdom. Okay, so taxonomic category, according to that, a taxon will be there. Now let me start with the species in detail. So first of all, what is a species? Okay, so species is a group of closely related organism and capable of interbreeding or reproduce to produce a fertile offspring. Okay, so this is a definition for the species, and it is the lowest category of any taxonomic categories. Okay, here are some examples. So if you are here, you can observe this common name is a mango. Okay, so here what is the scientific name for the mango? Mangifera indica. As you know very well, what is the binomial nomenclature? Okay, so first name indicates genus name and second name indicates species name. Okay, or a specific epithet. So here mango with the species name indica and Mangifera is a genus name. For the potato, you can see Solanum tuberosum. This is a scientific name in which Solanum is the genetic name. Okay, and the specific epithet is a tuberosum. Nightshade, Solanum nigrum. Then tomato, Solanum lycopersicum. Okay, so here the first name, whatever the first name written here, is indicating as a genera. Okay, and then second name, which is a small letter word you can see. Okay, and that indicating species name. Then brinjal, Solanum melongena, lion, Panthera leo, tiger, Panthera tigris, leopard, that is a Panthera pardus. Okay, then modern man, you know very well, homo sapiens. So these are some example of a species. Here you can see greenish color indicate the species name. Next category is a genus. Okay, that is a higher from the species. Okay, so it is the aggregates of closely related species. So many species together form genus. Okay, let me understand more by using these examples. So here you can see this is a potato, tomato, brinjals. Okay, potato, scientific name for the potato is a Solanum tuberosum. Okay, so here Solanum, a first letter or a first word indicating genus, and that is a Solanum. So inside the Solanum genus, you can see so many species are there. Okay, so potato is a Solanum tuberosum, then tomato is a Solanum lycopersicum, then brinjal is a Solanum melongena. So these are the example for the genus. Okay, then second genus, let me understand with the animal example. So genus is a Panthera. Okay, so you can see here lion, tiger, leopard. Okay, so lion having a scientific name with the Panthera leo. Okay, so leo indicating species name, but Panthera itself is a genus name. So you can understand, and you can see here a genus name may be same. Okay, but species name no, never be same. Here you can see Solanum, 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 each having a Solanum. Genus name is the same, but species name will never same. Okay, so same here also, a lion having Panthera leo. If you are just talking about Panthera, then you are very confused whether I'm talking about lion, leopard, or a tiger. Okay, but if I'm talking along with the species name, then you will clearly say what is I'm talking about. Okay, so lion having a Panthera leo name, then leopard Panthera pardus, then tiger having a Panthera tigris. Okay, so genus includes so many related, or better we can say that closely related species. Okay, and next genus is a Felis. Here you can see. Okay, so these both are a Felis. One is a house cat and second is a jungle cat. Okay, so here also you can observe Felis indicating genus name in the both cases. Okay, so here Felis indicating genus name and Domesticus indicating the species name. And similarly for jungle cat, you can see Felis indicating genus name and Chaos is indicating the species name. Next taxonomic category is a family, and it is a group of related genera. And family include here you can see some examples, two examples given here. So family Solanaceae include these all genus. Okay, so all genus together form a family. Okay, so here one example is given, that is a Solanaceae, and second example is given is a Felidae. This is the plant family and this is the animal family. Okay, so here you can see genus Solanum, genus Petunia, genus Datura. All these three genus are included in Solanaceae family. Okay, and if you are talking about animal family, Felidae. Okay, so genus Panthera and genus Felis, both these genus are included in the family Felidae. So it is a group of a related genera. Next to family is the order. So it is the assemblage of related families. So here you can see two examples is given. Okay, one is a plant order and second is the animal order. So let me see order Polymonials. Okay, that is a plant order. So here you can see it include two families. Family Convolvulaceae and second family is a Solanaceae family. Okay, so two families together form one order and that is Polymonials. Okay, and next example is a Carnivora order. So Carnivora order include two families, family Feridae and family Canidae. Okay, so these two family together form Carnivora. Next taxonomic category is a class. Okay, so what is a class? It is the assemblage of related orders. So, okay, so related order together form class. Here two classes are given. One class is of plant class and second is a animal class. So, plant class is a Dicotyledoni. Okay, and it includes two orders, Polymonials and Spinnerets. Okay, so these two order together form one class and that is a Dicotyledoni plants. Okay, and second class is the Mammalia, which is of animal, and that include two order, Primata and Carnivora. So two order together form one class and that is Mammalia. This is the case of animal. Next taxonomic category is a phylum or a division. So let me discuss when it is considered as a phylum and when it is considered as a division. So if you are talking about animals, so at that time you should utilize the word phylum. Okay, and if you are talking about plants, and at that time you have to utilize this terminology division. Okay, so let me discuss in detail. In division, we are talking about angiosperm. Okay, so we will discuss these all in detail, in each detail in chapter number 3 in very detail. So look at this. This is a division, angiosperm, and that include two classes, dicotyledony plants and monocotyledony plants. Okay, so these two class together form one division and that is angiosperm. Okay, and if you are talking about animals, so at that time you have to utilize a category name as a phylum. Okay, and that is a chordata. One example is given here is a chordata. So chordata includes so many classes. Here you can see class Amphibia, class Reptilia, then class Aves and class Mammalia. We will learn in detail in chapter number 4. Okay, in chapter number 4, we will learn Amphibia as a class in detail, Reptila, Aves, Mammalia, all these classes we will learn in detail in chapter number 4. So, this is a phylum. that is a chordata, and it includes four classes: amphibia, reptilia, then eels and mammalia. Next taxonomic category, and we can say highest category, is a kingdom. Okay, so the assemblage of related phyla or division, in case of animal it is phyla, in case of a plant it is division, but both together, okay, assemble it is, okay, then it is called highest category, and that is called kingdom. Okay, so here you can see almost two kingdoms are appear on the earth. Okay, and that is the kingdom Plantae, which include plants, and kingdom Animalia, which include animals. Okay, so here you can see division Angiosperm, division Gymnosperm. This all division together form one kingdom, and that is a Plantae. Okay, and all phylum together means Chordata, Arthropoda. Okay, this all phylum together form one kingdom, and that is animal. Now let me summarize by using this diagram. So here you can see this is the species. Okay, that is very lowest category. Okay, so all species together form genus. Okay, if genus together, it is formed family, and too many families form a order. Okay, and too many orders together form class. Too many classes together form phyla. Okay, and too many phylum together form kingdom, and kingdom together form domains. So this is all classification or a taxonomic categories. Okay, so here this is a very lowest category, and as you go upward, it will be form highest category. So highermost or uppermost category is a kingdom, or as we can say, a domains. Taxonomic categories which are used for plants and animals, both side, both are almost similar. Okay, but here you can see in both the cases species is there, in both cases genus is there, family is same, order same, okay, class is also same. But here in this stage you can see if a plants are there, these categories can consider as a division. And if you are talking about animals, at that time only the change is there, and that is called phylum. Rest other thing will be similar in both the categories for plants and the animals. So be very clear about this. When it is a case of a plant, you should utilize here a division. Okay, rest other is a similar to the animals, and if you are talking about animals, then you have to utilize the word phylum here. Rest other things are similar to the plants. Summarize all taxonomic categories with the example. So lowest category, let me start with the lowest category. Okay, so species name is a Tigris. So only one species is there. Okay, this is very specific, and that's why name is given species. Okay, so species name is a Tigris. So you can see here only one kind of a specific organism will be included in this. Okay, and then you can see here genus Panthera. So in the Panthera, too many other organisms are also there. So Panthera is there, lion is also there, tiger is also there, even leopards is also included here. Then family, if you are talking about family, then number of organism will be increased. Okay, then if you are talking about order, that is a carnivora, then more number will be increased. Then class mammalia, you can see in the mammalia too many other organisms are included. So if you go from lower category to high category, a number of organism will be increased. Okay, so number of organism type will be increased, organism included in the more amount. Okay, so you can see here, and if you go from highest to lowest, the number of organism will be decreased. Okay, so be very clear about this. You can see here, okay, and order carnivora, you can see class mammalia include more animals than phylum Chordata, than Animalia. So you can check the points. During first lecture of this chapter, I already told you this chapter is totally memory based chapter. Okay, so you have to remember so many things in this chapter, so many scientific name in the chapter. Okay, genus name, family name, order name, class name. Okay, then phylum name along with the spellings. Okay, so because why I am insisting this, because so many times these type of questions are asked in the NEET examination. So from the point of view of examination of a NEET exam, okay, this is very important. So try to remember this all. Okay, so let me discuss what is a common name here. So human or a man. Okay, the biological name or a scientific name for the human is a Homo sapiens. Now you are very clear, a first word indicating a genus name, and second name is indicating the species name. Okay, so be very clear, what is a family name? Hominidae. is a family, then order is a primata, class is the mammalia, and phylum, here we are talking about main, and main is included in the animal. That's why we are using as a phylum terminology, not a division. As I told you, division is used for the plants. So what is a phylum of the human is a chordata. Okay, now next is the housefly, that is also animal. So Musca domesticata is the scientific name for the housefly. Then the Musca is a genus name, family name is a Musidae. Okay, and the order is a Diptera. Then class is a Insecta, and phylum is a, here also I have to use the word phylum, not the division, because this is animal. Okay, so I have to use the terminology phylum. So phylum of these housefly is the Arthropoda. Next is the mango. Okay, and mango is a plant. So scientific name for the mango already we have learned in this chapter, Mangifera indica. Mangifera itself is a genus, species name is a indica. Then Anarchidaceae is a family name, spindles is the order name, Dicotyledon is a class name, and Angiospermae is a division name. Here I have to use the word division, not the phylum, because this is the organism of a plants. Okay, so if a plant is there, I have to use it, utilize this terminology, division. Next is a wheat. So scientific name for the wheat is a Triticum astivum. Here you can see a genus name Triticum, because first name is a Triticum and second is the astivum. So astivum is a species name. Then family name is a Poaceae. Order is a Poales. Okay, and class is a Monocotyledoneae. Then Angiospermae is a division name. Further, I have to use this terminology, division. So these all are the names you must be remembering. So today we are finishing this chapter, and on finishing this chapter, I am giving you two tasks. Okay, so first task is to write all remaining questions from the textbook exercise, and second thing you have to do is to solve all MCQs from exercise 1 from this chapter. And before we finish this lecture, let me summarize whole topic by using one animation video. So look at this video.
Our Earth is a habitat of millions of plants and animals, and new species are being discovered every day. In order to group these plants and animals based on observable characters, several taxonomists have classified them in a hierarchical structure that consists of ranks or categories. Every category is referred to as a unit of classification and is commonly termed as taxon. Since a category is a part of the taxonomic arrangement, it is known as a taxonomic category, and all categories together constitute the taxonomic hierarchy. Although the classification of living organisms seems difficult, you need to have a good knowledge of the characters of an individual organism or a group of organisms to classify them. This also helps you identify the similarities and dissimilarities among the same and different kinds of individual organisms. Organisms are classified using common categories such as kingdom, phylum or division, class, order, family, genus, and species. These taxonomic categories are also known as broad categories. Species is the basic rank in a taxonomic category. It is a group of individual organisms with fundamental similarities. You can distinguish one species from another closely related species based on morphological characters. Think of the varieties of mangoes available in the market, or the different species of rose in the garden. The next rank is genus, which consists of a group of related species that exhibit similar characteristics in comparison to species of other genera. In case of plants, the banyan and peepal trees have certain similarities, and therefore belong to the genus Ficus. Among animals, the lion, the tiger, and the leopard are closely linked, and thus are in the genus Panthera. However, the genus Panthera differs slightly from another genus, Felis, which includes cats. The next rank or category is family, which consists of a group of related genera with fewer similarities as compared to genus and species. For example, orange, lemon, and grapefruit belong to the family Rutaceae or the citrus family. Likewise, the lion, the tiger, the leopard, and the cat fall into the family Felidae. Although a cat and a dog exhibit some similarities and some differences, they are separated into two different families, Felidae and Canidae, respectively. Order is the next category, which is a collection of related families. However, the number of similarities is less than that seen in a family. For example, the order Lepidoptera includes butterflies and moths belonging to the families Papilionidae and Tinaeidae, respectively. Similarly, families like Felidae and Canidae are included in the order Carnivora, while plant families like Convolvulaceae and Solanaceae are included in the order Polymoniales on the basis of floral characters. The next category is class, which consists of related orders. Consider the two orders Primata and Carnivora. Order Primata includes the monkey, the gorilla, and the gibbon, while order Carnivora includes animals like the tiger, the cat, and the dog. Although these two orders are different, they are classified under the class Mammalia. Phylum or division is the next category. Animals like fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals have common features like the presence of notochord and a dorsal hollow neural system, and are thus categorized as phylum Chordata. Similarly, all flowering plants are categorized under the division Angiospermae or Magnoliophyta. The highest taxonomic category is Kingdom. All animals are put under Kingdom Animalia, and all plants fall under Kingdom Plantae. So, as we go higher from species to kingdom, the number of common characters goes on decreasing. Thus, by observing the characteristic features of an individual organism, taxonomists have classified living organisms into different taxonomic categories.
In next lecture, we will have a revision test 1 from chapter number 1, exercise 1. So, be well prepared for that. Until that, goodbye.